I know a number of other teams in the National League, the wild card discussion. So that raises the question, if you look at the last five starts of Bumgarner, who's been clutch in the postseason, as we know, Giants 3 World Series in the last decade here. Should the Giants, and I guess I'll start with you, Dontrelle, keep Bumgarner or trade him?
I'm from the area. The Giants hold a dear place in my heart. What he's done for that organization, I don't want to see him go, especially with Bochy departing after this year. But economically, he has to go. They need to get pieces for him that can help the organization dump the contract as well. He's probably almost likely going to walk anyway, so you want to get something for him. And honestly, are they really going to compete? Yes, they've been playing well the last couple of weeks, but are they really going to compete and really go deep into the postseason? Probably not. So you have to be honest about yourself and honest about the future of the organization moving forward, and you have to get rid of him.
Yeah, so I'm not sure I make a move unless I'm overwhelmed. And the reason I don't make a move unless I'm far on and I just get something that I can't turn down, I think from an emotional standpoint, you've got Boch, what he's done. And also from a public perception standpoint, you don't want to just say to the clubhouse and your fans, hey, we give up.
Right.
So if there's something that at least I can sell to my fans and say, well, look, I got this top prospect, this top guy, you know, I can't make the deal. And what I think will be interesting is if you package him with Will Smith, I think somewhere somebody will overpay for both of those guys.
Right.
And if you do that, then he goes.
Then the future with a new manager. And by the way, second most difficult of any team in baseball over the remaining portion of the season for the Giants. These are their opponents.
The schedule.
And see, that's what I mean.
You've
got to be honest about moving forward. Can we compete? Can we stay in the race? Can we really
give a shot? And if you get in,
what can you honestly do? You don't have enough depth in the rotation.
So if you get in and you're a Giants fan, and you get the Bochy send-off and Bumgarner starting that game, you're like,
right.
I don't care. I'm glad you kept them. So, you know, you get that emotional component, but you remove the feeling out of it, he gone.
To have that kind of pitching. So these are the, you know, we're over 100 regular season games, so you know where we go through the rest of the season to decide. And some of these teams could figure in the division as well in the race, but that's the way it looks at the moment for the wild card spot, that one-game playoff when they would face each other head-to-head. So, Eric, you're picking those two to stay?
Yeah, I'm picking the Nationals, and I think I'm going to go with the Phillies. And not the Phillies as currently constructed, but the Phillies, as my man Frank Thomas would say, see me in June, see me in about, you know, another week and a half.
Okay.
I just feel like they're all in. They pushed all their chips in this year, and they're not going to stop now. They're going to go out. They're going to try to make a big move, whether it's a pitcher, whether it's a position player.
Right.
They're going to make an impact move. Somebody's going to walk in that clubhouse, and guys are going to say, wow. And I feel they're going to do something, and that will enable them to be playing in October.
Yeah, for me, I do. I have the Nationals at the top of that wild card with the rotation and athleticism on the offensive side. I think they're going to maintain that. I have the St. Louis Cardinals. They're playing better baseball. They're defending. That bullpen has been lights out, especially with runners on, preventing guys to score. That's a huge weapon for them. Takes pressure off that young rotation, so they makes the game smaller. And Paul Goldschmidt, he's done this the last couple years. He's going to have a month where he hits 350 and hits 20 home runs in a month and even out his stats. He's going to heat up and carry that offense. And they're going to fight in that division and get that second wild card.
Yeah, so neither one think Milwaukee.
Well, I picked them to win a division, man.
St. Louis could win the division,
that's right.
Right? I mean, that's it's
take
crazy.
Take it easy over there,
General. He picked the Brewers?
I did. I'm sorry.
You didn't have to tell us.
There's nothing wrong with that. They're still right there.
I mean, they were there last year, a step away from the World Series, and nobody picked the Giants, although they're certainly putting on quite a run here to get in as a wild card.